A ripe heirloom tomato can be an epiphany. Soft, juicy, colorful, flavorful. So why are so many supermarket tomatoes tasteless and rock hard? Thanks to science, we know why these supermarket shams are so darn miserable, and what can be done to make supermarket tomatoes totally terrific. So the first thing you need to know is that tomatoes go through puberty just like the rest of us. That's what ripening is, a hormone-driven process that turns juvenile green tomatoes into mature fruits ready to spread their seeds and get cracking on the next generation. Tomato puberty kicks off with a simple molecule, ethylene. This hormone activates enzymes that build pigment compounds, such as red lycopene. And it activates enzymes that build flavor molecules, such as beta-ionone, which gives tomatoes a pleasantly floral odor of roses and violets, geraniol acetone, which adds leafy notes, and 6-methyl-5-heptan-2-one, which gives a citrus kick. Teenage tomatoes also produce enzymes that convert starch to sugar to sweeten the flesh, and enzymes that break down cellulose and pectin to make the fruit soft and juicy. Remember, this wonderful cascade of chemistry all begins with ethylene. And herein lies the root of the problem with supermarket tomatoes. Long ago, the produce industry began messing around with tomato puberty by breeding tomatoes to survive long-distance shipping and still look good, despite the jet lag. In the 90s, tomato breeders announced a breakthrough, a variety that remained hard during shipping and then ripened on supermarket shelves or in your fruit bowl. This travel-hardy variety has a mutation that curtails the production of ethylene, the ripening hormone. As a result, the biochemical drive to ripen in mutant plants is roughly half of what you'd find in wild tomatoes. Less ethylene means harder fruit and easier shipping, but it also means that there are fewer enzymes to produce flavor and sugar. This mutation essentially traps the popular supermarket tomato variety midway through adolescence. This is a fate I would not wish on any life form. There's more bad news. Decades ago, tomato breeders also decided that tomatoes should have a uniform red color. So they bred out the mottled green splotches you see in wild tomatoes and the heirloom varieties at farmers' markets. Unfortunately, this perfect complexion comes from a mutation in a gene essential for churning out chloroplasts in the developing fruit. Chloroplasts are organelles in plant cells that harness light energy to produce sugar. They're also responsible for the very many pleasurable flavor aromas found in tomatoes. That means the beautiful mutant tomatoes have less sugar and less fragrance. Turns out that beauty does really come with a price. Okay, so here's the good news. Researchers in Florida and China recently sequenced the genome of 398 different varieties of tomatoes. Wild varieties, heirloom tomatoes, supermarket charlatans, you name it. Using human tomato testers, the scientists figured out which flavor and odor chemicals customers liked. Then they tracked the 28 most prized molecules back to the tomato genes that made them. The team found that, surprise, surprise, most supermarket varieties make half of these molecules at vastly reduced levels. The researchers also found that when supermarket tomatoes are bred to be bigger, sweetness comes at the expense of bulk. With these discoveries, breeders now have the molecular markers to help them find a path to tastier supermarket tomatoes, although genetic engineering could restore all the great characteristics to tomatoes pretty much instantaneously. Consumers aren't keen for GMO fruits. But growers can still use slower, old-school crossbreeding methods to create a tomato with more desirable genes. As we wait for breeders to restore tomatoes to their former glory, here's a tip for getting the most out of your red fruits. Don't put the tomatoes in the fridge. Seriously, people, science has shown that chilling tomatoes blocks the production of flavor-making enzymes. Friends, do not let friends refrigerate tomatoes. Do you have any produce pro tips to share? Fire away in the comments.